Three Ducks Design. Go ahead and kick us off. Imagine an educational product that encourages creativity, ignites the imagination, is freeform, and unhooked. Think next generation Lego.
Together, we conceived and engineered an architecture set that integrates both STEM education with human experience and design thinking.
I designed the architecture sets, developed the website, as well as the packaging and branding.
And I did the two components of our sets on CAD.
Our mom brings over 20 years of experience as a pediatrician, ensuring that our product is developmentally appropriate. She is also our social media and marketing expert.
So what we did is we created a series of 6 3D printed connectors that are uniquely shaped, and they can build any complex structure. We also created cardboard shapes that are geometric, and they are made to be cut on a CNC routing machine.
Together, the biodegradable connectors and cardboard create architectural modeling sets used to design, build, and redesign anything a child can imagine. In the 6 months since we launched, we have done extensive market testing, working directly with children in schools, libraries, and some special events. We have studied how children use our product and how they benefit from Three Ducks Design architecture kits. For early childhood, using our product improves fine motor skills, teaches simple geometry, 3D spatial thinking, as well as communication and collaboration skills. In kindergarten through 8th grade, students learn more about complex geometry and engineering concepts, as well as problem-solving skills and deductive reasoning. We have optimized the connector morphology to fit a range of the most commercially available cardboard. Our young designers learn about creative repurposing and environmental responsibility. Think of a better way to reuse otherwise discarded shipping boxes. But most importantly, during our market testing, what we really learned is that everybody loves our product. Not a single set has been returned, and we are starting to get repeat customers. Three Ducks Design architecture kits offer an intuitive, high interest, and cost-effective platform for STEM education. We aim to sell direct to customers, schools, after-school programs, and children's museums.
So in the first 6 months that we've been open, we have gotten $18,000 in revenue. On top of that, we have a $4,000 profit. Our gross margins are only 77% also. And we did this all with a limited marketing budget of just $1,000. Our 2018 goals are to increase our business to customer sale. We want to get better at social media and go to larger venues. We also want to increase the business to education sales and business to business. With the $10,000, we would put that towards injection molding and the testing of injection molding. We would optimize die cutters and get high resolution 3D printers. Those printers will allow us to get better connectors and more complex shapes. We know our product, our mission, and our market. We have a clear pathway to success. We're asking you to help us bring Three Ducks Design architecture sets to homes and schools all across America.
You can yell if you need to, Mark.
I don't usually use a microphone.
Great presentation. So I'm curious, your direct-to-consumer segment, who's your target market? Who are you really going for in the consumer segment to buy this product?
So we would like to, our market is for children and adults, especially ages 4 and up. It is a choking hazard for kids under the age of 3, but we are selling to schools. Right now we are in 25 schools, both public and private, and they are using our product for educational purposes.
Hold on, I want to be clear. Your direct-to-consumer market, so what consumers, not schools, not organizations, are you trying to sell to?
More parents and children.
Okay, so you haven't broken it down any more than that.
So no, what you're trying to look at is, like, who specifically? Like, what is the ideal ages for the children? What are the family demographics that you're trying to target?
So we say ages 4 to 12.
But we're also capable of, if we can get into older people with older places for occupational therapy, it's good for people with strokes, and they can, instead of taking a ball out of putty.
Right, they can, I think, you know, when you have a market that's too broad, a small company can't possibly market to it because it's too broad, so I think we need a smaller segments, not bigger ones.
Okay.
Let me make a remark and then ask a question. When you are talking about marketing to kids, kids cannot buy. They are influencers. They can ask their parents to buy. But for this purpose, you need to have parents convinced that their kids will gain something from this. This is, as I understand, not the large investment on the parent side, but they are already preoccupied with so many different ads, different options, toys, and so on. That is why you need to find your own niche in this market. This is what I believe all judges are thinking about. And you need to understand who exactly you are targeting and how your message should be shaped to reach out to this audience. Another thing which I would like to ask, what about your intellectual property invested into this? How can you protect yourself from yet another company who will start next door, next state, across the ocean with a similar technology, maybe not exactly the same, but similar technology? How do you protect yourselves from this competition from maybe a company with deeper pockets?
Okay, so to answer the second part of the question, we have a provisional patent at the moment, and we are working with Mucon right now to get a non-provisional design and utility patent. We've done extensive market research, and there's new products like ours right now, so we are in that process. Okay. We also have a trademark.
When you say Mucon, do you mean
University of Connecticut?
Hmm?
Yes, University School of Connecticut, University of Connecticut, their IP clinic.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
In terms of testing and market testing, are you getting the same, what kind of feedback are you getting? Because 4 to 12 is a broad range, and is it the same kit for each age group?
So everybody is loving our product. We've gone to several markets. Parents love it. They can't get their children away from our product. So for younger kids, it helps teach them like fine motor skills, just even putting on the pieces and just figuring out the geometry of it. But then there's also the middle school students, and that helps. A lot of schools do have design programs where they have kids start their own versions of companies and prototyping, and our product really helps with the prototyping phase of that. So if, for example, a kid is making a chair, instead of using tape and cardboard to try to create a chair and then throw it away because they don't like it and restart, they can use our connectors, and therefore they can use trial and error, take it apart easily, and then it's all reusable.
Great. So for the older kids, it's more like a Lego kit, and for the younger kids, it's a prescribed Lego kit. Like,
yes.
If you're going to make this as a younger kid and as an older kid, you can do whatever you want with it.
Yes, and it also helps some of the connectors, as you can see, are 60-degree angles and 120-degree angles, so it helps teach kids more about the geometry, and if we have three 60-degree angles, they can make a triangle rather than a 90-degree angle, which would be a square.
All right, great job, guys. Thank you so much.